and I'm thrilled to say Cab from Eskimo Joe joins us right now.
Hey, guys.
Cab, welcome. First, I've got to check. Have we got black fingernails or not?
I don't. You know, I took out the nail polish before I left, and my wife actually asked me, should I put the polish on? And I was like, you know what? I think I'm going to skip it today. And now I'm regretting it. I'm like, that's right. That's my thing, isn't it?
The one day you got asked to be.
Yeah, exactly. Should have called each other. 25 years of Eskimo Joe. Does it feel that long?
Not really. I still feel like I'm about 24 in my mind, and I'm not 24 on the outside. Look, we have a lot of fun as a band, and so it feels very bizarre that we're getting to a 25-year mark because, you know, we've enjoyed every moment of it. We haven't sat there going, Jesus, we've been a band for a long time, haven't we? We thoroughly enjoy what we do, and so, yeah, I'm surprised it's been 25 years.
And you guys started in a band comp. Did you win it, or did Custard get you?
Well, we actually won it in Brisbane, funnily enough, home of Custard. But we started the campus band competition. So in Perth back in the day, to get a plane ticket out of Perth was a big deal. And the way to do that was to win the campus band competition. I didn't go to university, but Stu did and Joel did. And I think we used Joel's commerce degree that he was doing at UWA. And we got in there, and lo and behold, our fourth gig was the final, and we won it. And we got a package to record as part of that, and we recorded the Sweater EP. And then that got picked up on Triple J, and the rest, as they say, is history.
Absolutely. You're also hitting the road, which is very, very exciting.
So exciting.
Tones and I has admitted recently that she hates playing her biggest hit, Dance Monkey. She hates playing it. Are you in that boat, or do you love playing the hits?
I love playing the hits, but Sweater, the song we mentioned before, that was like almost a novelty hit for us, and we worked really, really hard once we started putting out records to be like a real band, you know, be thought of as a real band. But this, the funny thing is we're about to do this huge tour. We're playing Black Fingernails, Red Wine, and A Song as a City from start to finish. And in the encore, we might be throwing in some old songs that haven't been played for a long time. Whoa. So I'm just going to drop that and leave it there.
Okay.
Yeah. Excellent. So what are they?
Well, you'll have to wait and see.
It is great for us to be here in Perth, and I'm glad to speak to a Perth musician because I want to know what is the magic of this city when it comes to like the oversized impact of Perth on the Australian music scene is incredible, and I don't know what the explanation for it is.
Look, the thing about Perth I think is really lovely is that it's a great place to create. You know, it's a really supportive artistic environment, especially in Fremantle where we live. We've got, you know, Tame Impala, ourselves, John Butler, San Cisco, to name a few. But once you create that project, you've really got to take it out into the world because, you know, no one's going to come and visit you here and check your band out. So great place to create. I think we punch well above our weight because of that. And I'm glad the borders are open because we can go play live shows again.
Kev, if you're a West Aussie like me, then it's compulsory to go and see Eskimo Joe on multiple occasions. Yeah. I saw you once in New York at a little bar.
Oh, wow.
But the gig that you played at the AFL Grand Final just over the river here, what was that like?
I like to call it a sphincter-clenching moment. But, I mean, no one wants to blow the grand final. It's like the one gig where suddenly everyone's like, oh, you play in a band. You know, like everyone in Australia pays attention to music for the first time for all year. And it was a great honour to play it. And we just wanted to do the best possible job we could. And we enjoyed it. We wanted to enjoy the moment as well. And we got to do that.
Well, you didn't blow the grand final. The Bulldogs did, but you
How's things all right? You're not anxious? Sphincter's okay at
the moment? My sphincter's fine. This is not, you know, once you've done a grand final, you're fine. Your sphincter is good for life.
Sphincter health, apparently.
Yeah, that's right.
I had no idea.
Yeah.
See, the health tips are really extraordinary. I wasn't expecting this from Cap, but thank you very much. Tickets for Eskimo Joe's new tour, Black Fingernails, Red Wine in the City, are on sale now. Head to our website for the details. Cap, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah. Very great. I love you.